session going to be discuss about deadlocks which happen among the processes in a operating system comes under the module 3 as a session 1 going to be discuss about some part of the deadlocks going to be consider the topic called deadlocks how it appears and how it looks definitions and what are its major characteristics so maybe that prevention handling and mutual exclusion and burden weight and so much of characteristics go to be elaborate in detail resource allocation graph right so that is one data structure going to be exercise to understand how this resource are allocated or occupied right so those who got to discuss with help of this graph and how this deadlock we can handle after noticing the deadlock and prevent them prevent in future occurring the deadlock also can prevent there is a avoid also can avoid so the deadlock to certain extent can avoid them and also the for which the algorithm is going to be exercised to avoid this deadlocks so that may be one effort through the banker's algorithm and can see some of the numerical problems so let me begin this deadlock so deadlock is a noun you can observe what is a deadlock now that is a standstill suspended or it, maybe it is a stop that is standstill is resulting from the opposition of two equal forces or factions so verb tells about to bring to a such a standstill to bring to a such a standstill that is a verb of the deadlock dictionary meaning so you can see how the deadlock happen in our daily life also so there is a tug of war between this the people pulling other side and opposite side so there is a deadlock happen that right so this may be one example so disturbance can see that so there is a disturbance can observed in daily life the traffic sense that is so vehicles moving in direction of in the square or the circle of most of the cities so we can see that here deadlock happen so this car is moving and this car is moving towards the west side and this car is moving towards south side and again this car is moving what is called north side and can see that again this calling moving at east side so there is a here deadlock happen that right road blocked here right road blocks so why have this car have been abandoned right due to deadlock these are cars are standstill right it positioned static that it's no more moves allowed here right so that is a disturbance we have experience in our daily life so similarly in system also it causes and model you can see that is characterization and handling the deadlock so prevention also avoidance also detection recovery from the deadlock so objectives are here prevent set up concurrent process from completing their task so can prevent them which happen concurrent process for the avoiding the deadlock right so to present a number of different method for preventing and avoiding the deadlocks in critical section right so that prevention is better than cure so that prevention effort is also happening before entering into the critical section so why it so happen the lack of process synchronization so the lack of process synchronization so we have studied enough about synchronization mechanism so maybe that semaphore and test and set and swap and compare and swap, right? In spite of that also, there is a timing overlapping happen, so that synchronization may not completely achieve that. So that deadlock will be happen. So problem of multi-programming system, right? So that the permanent blocking of setup process, the occur on a shareable resource. It mostly occur in a shareable resource, that is shared variable. So particular event that will not occur, some of the particular event, so that may not occur. So the properly managed and the process execution, so hardly matter, very rarely some of the time it may not occur, but most of the time it occur. So you can see the model for the system deadlock occurrence. So system consists of resource, so that is a, let's say, resource R1 R2 R3 Rm, so maybe IO, maybe printer, maybe memory data, right? So maybe some shared variable, resource type those there. CPU cycle, memory space, IO devices, right? CPU cycle, memory space, so IO devices are the example of resource type. So other each resource type RI has a WI instances, right? So each resource have their several instances possible. So here each process utilize the resource as follows. So it utilize, that is the resource request may be there. After granting, then use may be start. Maybe we are discussing about that acquire a lock, enter a critical section, and release that, right? In that sense, request, use, and release those resource. After performing those operation, it has to be released back, so that other process waiting for that resource, so they can beneficiary. Otherwise, they will be wait. The long time they be waiting, that is, though have priority. So characterization, we can see, so it can arise if the four condition hold simultaneously. So what are the four conditions? So let we see that mutual exclusion, we have seen that. So only one process at a time can use a resource. So the process one, resource one, so resource one has to be utilized by process one at a given time. No other process to request that that resource one, right? So that the only one process, for example, P1 looking for resource R1, the resource R1 has to be utilized by only P1 process. So until and unless completion of that, after completing P1, then next P2, P3, or so on, any other process can utilize the resource R1. So that true even many resource. So that is a mutual exclusion we discussed enough in the previous session. Hold and wait. A process holding at least one resource is waiting to acquire additional resource held by other. So hold, one resource is hold, it waiting for another resource. Maybe complete certain task, it needs some resource, additional resource, right? So only after getting additional resource, that holded resource is worth to hold, and it completes the operation and it may release that. So this is a hold and wait. This is one of the characteristic of the deadlock. It holding one resource at requesting one more resource, right? So the no preemption. Resource can be released only voluntarily by the process holding it after that process has completed task. We have seen that preemption. No preemption means forcibly we cannot remove that resource or disallocate the resource. So that naturally, that as and when that operation completes, it may release automatically. So that no preemption in the that is also one characteristic of the deadlocks. Circular wait, right? So consider the situation: process one, process zero, process one, process three, so on, process n processes are waiting for the process such that resource. So P0, process zero is waiting for the resource which held by the P1. Process P1 holds some resource, but that resource needed for P0. So that is waiting. P0 waits for resource held by the P1. So similarly, P1 waiting for the resource that is held by P2. Right? So P0 waiting for the resource P1. So P1 holding the resource, additional resource is waiting from the P2. Right? P2. So that dependency will be there. So Pn minus 1 is waiting for the Pn, and Pn is holding for the resource of P0. So one circular starts from P0, P1, P2, Pn minus 1, Pn. So circular wait. So there is exist a circular wait. So that is also one observation of happening the deadlock in frequently, right? Finite number of resource, right? So finite number of resource, you can see that. So that is what are the resource you can see? Reusable resource. So reusable resource are there. So reusable resource and the consumable resource. So consumable resource also may be there. So there is a two type of resource you can absorb, which process going to be acquire or request. So that reusable process, that is used by process at a time, one process at a time. Reusable, it is used by one process at a time. So my example, processor files, that processor, that hardware. So that is only one processor can hold at a, used by the processors. Files, one file is open, and only one process can use that. The other process, we cannot allow that, because there is a files going to be shared variable. So let allow one process to modify any, if they wish to modify according to their computation, let them modify. Once it is completed and it release that files, so that files will be next, who is waiting for modify or use that, so they can give to them. So the database also, similarly database, particular process want to modify some database, let them modify. So no other can allow during the same time. So multiple cannot allow during the same time. So it will be in a different time. So that also main memory, also secondary memory, also semaphore, also we have seen that IO channels also. So this is only one process can use at a given time. That is a resourcer. So reusable or files, database, main memory, secondary memory, so on that. So let come to secondary memory, consumable can be created and destroyed. So can be created, maybe record activation, so file creation, right? So those are there. So interrupts are there. So that will be created system through the interrupts, through system calls, consumable signals, no? Signals, messages in buffer. So these are called consumables. So this type of resource and finite number of resource, reusable and consumable. So we can talk more about this. Let we see in the subsequent discussion. So that reusable and consumable type of finite number of resource is going to be exercise. So there is one more the more important is a data structure for this deadlock handling in a computer. So that resource allocation graph, through this data structure, so we can handle the deadlocks. Right, deadlocks with a three process. For example, you can see, so that could be n number of process in a system. For example, to highlight this resource allocation graph, so the three process will be there. So we have P1, is waiting for R1, so it is utilizing R1, and P2 holding R2, P1 holding R1, P2 holding R2, right? So then P1 also additional is requesting R2. It holding R1, but it request R2 also, right? So in order to complete some operation. So similarly, so P2 the P3 holding R3, no? So similarly P2 request additional one. So that is, so similarly R3 request R1, sorry, P3 request R1. P3 P3 request R1. So that is a deadlock, circular wait. So circular wait will be there. So I hope you understand. So that three process and three resource are involved, and this is a reallocation graph, right? So the reallocation graph, we can see that. So let we see in a more professional way. A set of vertices V and set of edges E. So V is partitioned into two types, right? The vertex is partitioned into two types. So those are process and resource, right? So process is a P1, P2. The setup consists of all the process in the system. So resource are R1, R2, Rm. So M resource, N process, right? The setup consists of all the resource types in the system. So this vertices partitioned into those are process and resource, right? So N process, M vertices, sorry, M resource, those are all going to be vertices. So request edge, request edge means, so directed edge pi to rj. So the p1 to r2, no, p1 to r2 is the requested edge. So this r1 to p1 is a holding edge, right? It is already holded. So the requesting additional resource, so pi and pj, that p1 to r2. So assignment edge, that is assignment is a directed edge rj to pi, right? Rj to pi, that is assignment edge, you can also call it as. So here that resource allocation graph, we have a process with more the flowchart type, the process with a circle, and resource type with four instances, we can see. So this is a rectangle R square. It is a four instances are there, this four boxes inside, box inside a box. So four dots are, four boxes are there, four instances are there, resource type. And process type, that is RIZ, that is PI to RJ. So that is a requesting, that is instance will be there. And PI is holding an instance RJ, so that we have seen, so in the previous example. So this RJ holding, P1 holding RJ, no? P1 holding RJ, so that assignment gets. So here we can see P1 and P2, that R2 have two instance. So here we have seen the example 4, no? 4. So here two dots are there. So here four. So for two dots are there, two process. So two process, the R2 can have instance, instance for P1, instance for P2, like that can have that. So here also that resource one, that is requesting. So requesting, that is P1 requesting R1, P2, R1 is holded by the P2, R1 is holded by the P2. So here, so R3, P2 is requesting R3, and it is holded by P3, right? So here R4 have three instances. So we can repeat, R1 have one instance, R1, R3, two instance. So R2 have two instance, R4 have three instance, three dots are there, huh? So that is a resource allocation graph, you can see that. So basic facts here, if graph contains no cycles, then no deadlock. It is some rough estimation. So graph do not have it increases the cycles, so no deadlock. So graph contains a cycle, there is chances of deadlock. So if only one instance per resource type, then the deadlock. So the cycle is there and only one instance per resource type, then deadlock obviously, because that process occupied one, and if somebody requests, then no other resource will be available. If many instances are there per resource, then possibility of deadlock. Now guarantee, there is a possibility of to avoid a deadlock, or it is a deadlock is there if many instances of resource type is there, right? So let we see example, previous one we repeated here. We can see R1 and R3 have one instance. Okay, this dot, no? R1 and R3 have one instance. So where R2 have two instance, R4 have three instance, we have seen in the previous, right? So let me see one more example. So here we have, so the resource 1, resource 2, 1 and 2 have two instances, right? So one instances, so we can have that assignment and adds claim adds, right? So let me see here a deadlock, the cycles are there, so deadlock will be occur here, right? So P2 R3 and P3 is R2, so that is occupied by P2 and P1, so it is not giving at all. I think it is busy waiting. So here deadlock will be possible. So here cycle with no deadlock, here cycle is there but no deadlock. So because if many instance per resource type is there, no? So that's why the deadlock, no chances of deadlock here. So because of here two instances are there, it is giving one to P1 and other to P3, right? So P4, that no deadlock will be there. So method for handling a deadlock, guarantee that system will never enter deadlock state. There is a prevention and avoidance of the deadlock. So allow the system to enter a deadlock state and recollect that. Ignore the problem and pretend the deadlocks never occur in the system used by the most of the operating system, especially Unix system. So that prevention, restrain the way the request can be made. So mutual exception, we have seen, not required for shareable resource. Read only files, must hold a non-shareable resource. Hold and wait, must guarantee that whenever process request additional, it does not hold any other resource. So require a process to request allocate its resource before start execution, or resource only when the no allocated to it. So that hold and wait, we need to be carefully observe that. So low resource utilization or starvation possible, the process suffer from non-availability of the resource, so that due to the hold and wait. So this prevention, the no prevention, we have seen in previous discussion. A process that holding some resource request another resource that cannot be immediately allocated to it, then all resource currently being need to be released. Preempted resource are added to the list of resource for which the process is waiting. So here the process will be restarted only when it can be regain its old resource as well as the new ones when it is requesting. So old resource also required because it holds some information of earlier computation. So along with the request, the latest one is, even though available, the old, along with the old resource, this would be available. Circular wait we have seen. So that is a total adding up, ordering of resource types. Each process request a resource in the increasing order of enumeration. So we can have avoidance. The system has additional prior information available. Then the simplest and most useful model require each process to declare a maximum number of resource, each type that is may be needed. So the pre-access, no, it has to be declare how many number of resource they needed in the future or in short time. So that can be a deadlock avoidance algorithm. Dynamically examine the resource allocation states to ensure that there is a can never be a circular wait condition. So that we need to be avoid circular conditions, wait condition. Allocation state is defined by the number of available and allocated resource, the maximum demand of the process. So what are the resource available, out of which how many we have already given, right? So the maximum, what is the demand of the process, right? What is the maximum demand, how many, how much are available, and in that how much we have already given, right? So these three parameters going to be play a vital role when resource allocation state is to be study or understand, right? So it is a safe state. When a process requests an available resource, system must decide if immediate allocation leaves the system in a safe state. So that should be decided. If immediate allocation leaves the system in a safe state, so in that case we can decide that is. So safe state is a that is a P1, P2, Pn, right? All of these process in the system such that they are each Pi, the resource type Pi can be satisfied by currently available resource plus resource held by all the Pj with the j is less than L, right? So here the safe state we have P1, P2, P3. For example, three processes are there, then P1, P2, P3. So that is a safe state, right? So P1 got resource and went into this one, avoiding deadlock. P2 also, P3 also, or P2, P3, P1. For example, P1, P2, P3 we consider. P1, P2, P3 is a lucky, as also holds, or P2, P3, P1, or any sequence P2, P1, P3 like that. So that is a safe state. Safe state. All the process that system such that for each Pi, resource Pi can still exist satisfied the currently available resource plus held the resource. So that is a if Pi resource needs are immediately available, Pi resource immediately, then if Pi can wait until Pj have finished is available, but it has to wait till Pj has finished that. So when Pj finishes, the Pi can obtain the what is the needed resource, execute, return the allocated resource and terminate. Right. So when Pi terminates, Pi plus 1 can obtain its needed resource, so on that is. So basic facts here, if system is in a safe state, no deadlock. So that is a system is a safe state we consider here. So this may be a safe, this may be a deadlock, non-safe state, non-safe. So this is a safe state, system is in a safe state. So we have seen that P1, P2, P3. If system is in unsafe state, no, then possibility of deadlock. In system in safe, then no deadlock possible. So we have system is in unsafe mode, then possibility of deadlock. That is a unsafe, that is a deadlock may be possible. So from this figure we can understand safe, this portion, unsafe. So unsafe may be possible, deadlock here no possible because the system is safe. So that is avoidance. They ensure that system will never enter the unsafe state. System will never enter the unsafe state. So that we have to carefully observe that. So single instance of the resource type. So use a resource allocation graph. Avoidance algorithm. So use a resource allocation graph. So that have single instance of the resource type. So can have that. So multiple instance of resource for a single instance resource type, no problem. That single resource allocation graph is a data structure is enough to avoid the unsafe or enter into deadlock. Where in the multiple instance that resource allocation graph may not enough. So in that case, we can go for the Banker's algorithm. Right. So I'll repeat once again, the RAG is enough for single resource type, whereas multiple instance of the resource type is there, then for which the safe system is computed or avoided by a Banker's algorithm. So RAG, that is a claim edge, that is RA implies RJ, indicate that the process PJ may request the resource RJ, denoted by the dashed line. Pi request that RJ, indicate that process PJ may request that is RJ, that is a claim edge, we call it a dashed line, right? P1 to R2, that is a dashed line. So Pi request the RJ, the P1 request a R2, so that process PJ may request So both requesting the same resource. So let me see, if R2 have two instance, then luckily it's possible, no deadlock. So claim heads convert into request heads when a process requests a resource. So this claim heads, that is P1 to R2 or P2 to R2, can convert into request heads. So request heads convert into assignment heads when the resource is allocated to the process. So when it allocated, you can assignment heads. When resource released by the process, assignment heads converted to claim heads, right? It started from the claim heads to request heads to assignment heads, and release. Once release, it become again claim heads. So other process can request those resources. Resource must be claimed prior in the system. In advance, that resource should be accessed. That is a claim. So in advance, it has to be request. So here similarly, we have that resource claim, that is given, that is, so in advance they can, so it is whenever it's available, it given to P2, that is, it become unsafe state in the RIJ. This become unsafe state. So the R2 here is not allocated, it still is in a claim heads. So where the other heads, claim heads cannot request, requests cannot assignment heads, so it led to a P2, right? So P2 can finish their job. This unsafe we can indicate from this resource allocation graph, where there is only one instance will be there. So it is a, suppose that process PI request a resource RJ. So then request can be granted only if the converting requested to be an assignment heads does not result in the formation of the cycle in the graph, right? It may not form a cycle. So in the cycle, no cycle is there, it is a unsafe, right? So we can have a banker's algorithm for multiple instances. So each process must prior claim maximum use. So when process requests a resource, it may have to wait. When process requests a resource, it may be wait, that is, when process gets all its resource, it must return then the finite amount of time. So that discipline has to be exercised. Data structure for banker's algorithm, that number of process n and number of resource m. N process, m resource. So available vector length of m means resource type m, no? n m resource are the, that length of the vector. If available j is equal to k, there is a k instance of the resource type RJ available. K instance, this is a kth instance of the RJ available, resource type RJ available. So that is a matrix n into m, that is a maximum I comma j, that is k process may request most k, no? P1 can request most k instance of the resource type RJ. So allocation matrix, that is allocation ij is equal to k, then pi currently allocated k instance of rj. Need is a demand, no? Demand. So n into m matrix, that is need is equal to k, then pi may need k more instance rj to complete that task. That is, if need can compute, demand can compute maximum minus allocation. Maximum is a what are the resource we can have, maximum we can give, and available how much we have. So what is that allocation we can allocate it, and demand of this entire system. So that can be computed, maximum minus allocation. So this is a maximum minus allocation will give a need, right? So need can see that availability. So this demand, that because the process put demand in advance, no? So those advance we can compute. So that advance we can compute and make sure that this we have this much available, and among this we can give this need, right? If need is more and available less, then it may be stop, right? So let we algorithm in a more disciplined way. Work and finish the vector length. So work is equal to available, finish size is equal to false, I is equal to 1 to n to minus 1. So find I such that finish I is equal to false, need is less than work. So if no such I exist, then go to step 4. Right, finish equal to false, need is less than work. So work is equal to work plus allocation. So finish is equal to true. Go to step 2. Right, so false, then need is less than or equal to work, then only we can go. Then finish that here. No? Need less than work, no such gets, so go to step. Finish I equal true for all, then system is a safe state. So these 4 steps of the banker's algorithm going to be exercise. So anyhow, we'll see some problems, then will be more clear. So request is a vector process PI. If request J is equal to K, then process PI want to K instance of the resource RJ. So request is less than the need. Request is less than the need, go to step, otherwise raise the error condition. So since the process has exceeded its maximum claim, request is less than available, then go to step 3, otherwise PI must wait since the resource was not available. Pretend to allocate the resource requested resource to PI by updating the state as follows. Available is equal to available minus request. Allocation is equal to allocation plus request. Available is equal to available minus request. Allocation is equal to allocation plus request. So need is equal to need minus request. Right? Available to allocation to need. Right? So this 3 statement we should remember. If state, if safe, then resources are allocated to PI. PI. If unsafe, PI must wait. Hold resource allocation, state resource, that is. So let me see the problem in this direction. So the banker's algorithm going to exercise the numerical problem. So here consider system consists of 5 resource process P1 to P5. 5, you know. So and how many resource? 3 resource, R1, R2, R3. So I am narrating once again. The problem not to solve with the help of the banker's algorithm. We know that multi-process going to be involved in that such case. RAG we have seen for single instance. Here multiple instances are there for which we can go to banker's algorithm. So in that case, 4-5 process consider as an example, and 3 resource. And R1 has 10 instance of type, R2 have 5 and R3 have 7. So R1 10, R2 5, R3 7 instances. Following snapshots, okay, let me see that. So here the allocation resource R1, R2, R3 and P1, P2, P3. So P1 allocated 0, P2 allocated 1 and P3 0. So similarly, you can see that R1 have 2 plus 3 plus 5, that is 5, 7. R1 have 7, but R1 have 10 instance. So R2 have 5, so this is 2. R3 have 7, no? So R3 7 is P5 is there, still there. So this is a allocation, we can see that. And similarly, maximum, what is that? Maximum R1, R2, R3, maximum P1, 7, 5, 3, you know. 3, 2, 2, 9, 0, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 3, 3. So this data given by the in the problem. So available is R1, R2, R3, 3, 3, 2. Available R1 have 3, R2 have 3, R3 have 2. But here in the problem they said 10, 5, 7. No matter. Those are instances. But currently these are available. Other remaining are occupied by some process. That is a sense here. So R1 have 10, R2 have 5, R3 have 7, out of which currently at the given instant of time 3, 3, 2 is available, right? That's all the problem clarification. So content matrix needed, content of the matrix need to calculate it, that is a need is equal to what? That is a need is a demand. Demand minus demand is equal to maximum minus allocation. So maximum minus allocation. So here we can have. So in that effort, So we have a need. We can going to be compute that process one. Let me see what is a need that is a process one. So maximum of this 753, no 753 minus allocation is a 010. So 753 minus 010 is going to be become a the available. So we can 743 that 010 743. So maximum is a 753. The available is zero. Sorry, allocation is 010. We can subtract this. We'll get 743. No, so 743 is a 743 is recorded here P1. I hope you will understand. I'll repeat once again. Need is equal to max minus allocation. So in the case of process P1, so what is a max? Max is a 753, and what is a allocation is 013. So subtract them. We'll get 743. 743 R17. R24 and R33, right? So this is a for the P1 process demand is P1 is a putting its demand in order to avoid a deadlock in future. So for the system is requesting this much I need, right? P1 is putting this demand. So let me see. P2 is also similarly. P2 is a 322 minus 206. That is a 122. Similarly, 433. Last one P5 you can see 433 minus 002. So that is a 431, right? So this demand we computed. I hope you followed this problem. So let me see, compute the same sequence. So same sequence is calculated here. Need process compared to the available. If need is less than available, then the processor allocated to the process and allocate. Otherwise, it won't allocate. So need is less than the available. So what we have available is a 332. What is a need for a case 743 is a huge demand is there, so it may not so, right? So if need is greater than the available, next process need get a chance, right? So if above example need process P1 is a need is a how much say 743, what is available 332, right? So 332 the P1 putting a demand in advance, 743 according to banker's algorithm. It expect the advance booking, so advance reserve what they want. So in that sense, the P1 sent 743, but they have only 332. So the need is greater than available. It is false. So system will move for the next process. So P1 will not get a chance to acquire the resource. So that is a conclusion. I will repeat that is need is greater than the available. So 743 is a demand. So available is 332 is greater than. So that is a false case. So it not now the P1 is not allowed here. So let's go for P2. Give a chance to P2. What is a P2 have? 122, right? So what is available? 332, right? So need is less than available. So now there is a bright chance to allocate the resource for P2, right? So P2 is 122, right? So available is 332, right? Definitely is less than one, less than that. So the P2 get a chance to enter. So in order to enter, get a chance, we can P2 do that is true. Finish I, that is a P2 is granted. The process P2 is a release a resource to that is work equal to work plus allocation, right? We need to compute a work is equal to work plus allocation. So that is a work is what is that 332, no? Work is a 332 plus allocation 200, so 532. So this procedure is continued for all the process. Now P2 got a chance in order to compute that P2 allocate the resource that the 332 is available work that is and the max allocation that is 200. So including that 532 will become available. So next P3 get a chance. P1 got a chance. P2 got. So now P3 we can look that. So P3 that is a 600 is a compute with the available that 533. So P3 have 600, no? So what is that? So P3 have here you can see 600. So P3 have 600. So the P3 have 600. So that's why. So that P3 have 600, which is greater than 532. No? 532 is available now. This is 532. So P3 will not get a chance. So we'll give it a P4. P4 need is 011. So from that table we can refer. Compare with available 532. So 532. So need is less than available. So 011 is less than 532. So we can give a chance to P4. So available we can compute 532 plus 211. What is a 21? 211 we can see that P4. No. So P4 is allocation is 211. So P4 is allocation 211, that will be added to the available, that become what is that 743. So that becomes 743. So we have allowed P2 and P4, right? So P1 and P3 are not allowed due to non-availability of the resource. So then process P5 get a chance now, is in the queue. 431 is compute with available 743. So available is 743. So 431 is one less than the 743. He will get a chance. So in order to give a chance, that allocation 743 plus 002, that 745 is available. So the new one cycle is completed. So P1 prevented, P2 got a chance, P3 prevented, P4 got a chance, and P5 also got a chance. P2, P4, P5 got a chance. So we can go for second cycle. So there left one, that is P1 and P3, no? So they might got a chance because that availability now demand increases. So one cycle is complete. Again, system has a take all the remaining process in the request. So process P1 needs 743. P1 need 743. Now we have to give a chance to P1. No? In the first cycle, it missed that. So because that it was huge demand and availability was very less. So now the heaped by many that 743 is there compared with available is 745. So it definitely satisfied. So now we can give it a chance to P1. So P1. He have allocation that 010. After adding that 755 is a new available. So now P3 was left now in the first cycle. Now give it a chance to P3. So P3 need a huge demand, that 600 is compared with the new available 75. Definitely is also getting chance, that need is less than available. True, that is true. So 600 less than 755. Then we can add 755 with allocation, that is 302 of P3. No, 302 is a P3 allocation. So that will be added with available. Then you will come 1057. So I add all this 1057. So that is a new available. So we can recall our problem started with R1 10, R2 5 instance, R3 have 7 instance. No? So that is matched here. So that can be safe sequences. We can allow the process, let enter P2 first, then P4 first, second, and P5 third, P1 fourth, P4 last. Right? If in this sequence we allowed the process and system is safe, no deadlock will be occurred. So that is the beauty of the banker's algorithm. So I hope you followed that is. So let me see one more problem. Consider following that snapshots here. What is how many 4 resources are there? So allocation, request, available are there. And here the snapshots, we have 5 process and 4 resource. So here answer the following questions with the banker column. What is the contents of the need matrix? We need to compute the need matrix. So is the system safe state? So the calculation. If the request from P2 arrives 0420, can be requested granted immediately. So first we compute the need. No? Need, what is a need? Need means maximum minus available allocation. Maximum that to need mat. Is the system safe? So the calculation that we have seen in the previous problem in the order of P2, P4, P5, P1, P3, that is safe. So no? in that sense, it's safe or not. If request P2 arrives 0420, can be allocated. So that is a problem here. So let me see the content need matrix. We can see that need is equal to max minus allocation. So max minus allocation, we have allocation, we have that is 010. So that is computed, we have given that is 050, and need matrix is there. So we can have a safe state P100. P1 is a 00 and available is a 1520. Available is 1520. So we can see that that is a P1 new available allocation is allowed now. So less than that, then total is computed. So that P1 is allowed. P2 we can see 0750. Available is 1532. So need is more. So it is not available. So request is not granted. So now available is 1532. Can give a chance to P3. P3 1002. The need is available, less than available, and it is allowed. So then we can have 10 instead of that P3. 1350 is added. 1532 that is available. Two then total 2886. Then we have allowed the pre-process P4 is 0020. Available is 2280 86. So then need is less than. So new available can allow them P4. So P5 is a 064 available. So then will be need is less than available. Then we can add them. So will become 2412. So that can be allowed. That is system is safe. So from these two problems, we have clearly understood the banker's algorithm and the previous problem that resource allocation graph, in which we have one instance of the resource, whereas a multiple instance of the resource, it can allow the multiple process. Then the in order to have a in advance to get a demand from the all the process, for that need we need to compute it and exercise the banker's algorithm, which is going to be compute and tells about what is a safe system, in which order we can allow the process to enter into the execution. So that is the best way to avoid from this two algorithm. I hope you followed clearly. So we have understood the Ridloc concepts and those characteristics, allocation graph for the single instance, and handling prevention avoidance can be with help of this Bankel algorithm. In the case of multiple instance of the multiple process we want to entertain in the internet the execution. So the problems we have seen. So let me see some more problems in the subsequent class. I hope you followed clearly. So thanks for the interest you shown. We got the material from the Abraham Silverstein et al. From the textbook, and there is also additional reference books are there. And thank you for patiently hearing, listening and so on, and interest on deadlock portion as a part 1, as a session 1 of module 3. Thanks to coordinator, moderator and subjects expert. Thank you one and all.